Everybody, just wanted to do a quick video on recent events that have happened in my household and how they translate to what we're experiencing at large. So last week was a little tough. I have very few rules in my household. It just makes things easier to manage and it makes things easier on my daughter. And last week she broke a rule. It was really tough. It was really frustrating that this rule was broken because, yeah, I don't have a lot of rules and they have a significant reason behind why I set the rule and everything. So this kicked off a pretty in-depth discussion between her and I about that and what happened and what was going on and, you know, establishing my expectations for the household and what's reasonable, what's not. So we discussed, we agreed on things, and the next morning when I woke up, things still weren't taken care of, and I bring her over, I'm like, come over here, there's something I want to show you, you know, this issue is still going on, this still happened, and instead of receiving that, instead of going, oh, okay, I see that now, I see what, you know, is disappointing or upsetting about this, instead of doing that, she latches onto the subject matter of like a specific item and then goes on a tangent, on a complete defensive tangent that it wasn't there and blah blah blah, and I'm like, but you went over here to look for the item and you left the stuff out. Long story short, once again it kicked off this other discussion, but within me it showed me that I wasn't dealing with the actual problem or where the problem began. And the problem begins with why she was being defensive. And defensivity is a protection mechanism. It is there to kind of protect you when you're feeling threatened. So something about having a problem made her feel threatened in these moments. And so we did a whole exercise around that and started figuring some things out and uncovering like interesting issues of where I can handle things better or be more mindful of how I am passing information along. But it also helps her to connect with her emotions and understand in these moments she's not being threatened. We're working through problems. These are teachable moments so that at least from my perspective, I'm trying to teach her to learn and grow and be able to handle herself as an adult and her household. Needless to say, this translates to what's happening with the Black Lives Matter movement, where we have these conspiracies, these other agendas kind of cropping in. And one of the main issues you'll come across, and I'm pretty sure you've come across it already, is when someone's like, Black Lives Matter. Someone comes along and goes, All Lives Matter. And they're not even a vegan. So, obviously there's multiple problems with that. First off, it detracts from the point. The point is, yes, all lives matter, but right now, we need to address this one really big problem of Black lives mattering within this culture, country, and several others as well. And another thing about that is it's not an effective communication technique. But before I go into the effective communication technique, I am going to say that it's not a good way to address things. But also on the Black Lives Matter side, I have to kind of poke at that too, where I question, why aren't we just ending the debate by going, all lives matter when Black lives matter? And then we unify everybody because everyone's being heard in that moment. So now skipping forward, after I covered that, skipping forward to communication techniques. When you're with your spouse or significant other, say you've had that experience, and you go, hey, hon, you forgot to wash the dishes last night. I woke up and the sink is just full. And I spent all yesterday cooking for 3 hours and this didn't happen. And instead of your spouse going, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry, I completely brain farted, I got sucked into social media, let me get on that right now. They start going, oh, well, you know what, you didn't cook the night before. So, you know, maybe it's your turn to do the dishes instead, because just like, give me some slack, just give me slack, because you didn't cook the night before. So that kind of escalates into a fight where the person who brought up the first problem is obviously not being heard because they're being met with defensivity. And that defensivity prevents learning. It prevents any sort of correcting of the problem. It prevents a whole host of things from happening to get you guys to working together and to solving your problems and making amends. So furthermore, going on with conspiracy theories, are they helpful? Are they actually helping to educate people about things? Because I agree that people need to be aware of what's going on behind the scenes. We're all inundated with Black Lives Matter right now, but there are things that are happening. There are trials that are happening. There are certain laws that are being enacted. There's other things happening that you really do need to be aware of. But with the conspiracy theories right now, there's a lot of photoshopped images out there, a lot of BS kind of just sucking people in and removing their critical thinking skills, pretty much. And that's not helpful to anybody. It's not helpful to a movement. It can often be triggering. People get cycled into this trigger state of trauma where it's like, oh my gosh, there's this other thing going on, and there's this thing going on behind the thing going on, and it's not helping anybody. It's a big distraction. It's like a blindfold. So, you know, it just triggers a whole nother thing where we are not unified on a front, where we're not solving our problems. And it's another way of creating disinformation and distraction. So I want you guys to be aware of that. Be aware of your behaviors. Be aware of the things that you're saying. Be aware of the conspiracy theories that are not healthy for you, that are bringing you down into maybe a bad space vibrationally. Let's put that out there. So also, if you are having a hard time being heard, I'm here to listen. I don't care what rants you have. I'm here willing to work through these things, because a lot of it, as I mentioned, it's a trigger state. It comes from a trigger state where you are feeling threatened, where you are feeling, you know, there's the white guilt going on, which actually is going on, by the way, and is not cool because it doesn't solve the problem and it doesn't help anybody. So if you need a vent, if you need to talk about things, I'm here to listen. I do have free sessions right now. As always, reach out, and I'm willing to hear you, to help you through this in a non-judgmental space, because that's not helpful, right? So be well. I hope that this helps to clear up and maybe correct a few things that I've noticed that are going on. So love you guys. Have a good night.